Shalom. In many weekly portions, a rabbi or a scholar has to look very hard in order to find a message for our time. And they resort to midrash and homiletics. That is not the case with Parashat Chaye Sarah. In one chapter, in Bereshit chapter 24, we have four very basic Jewish values. The first value is Zionism, which of course goes back 3,800 years to the time of Avraham Avinu. And we read in chapter 24, "And the servant said to him, 'What if the woman does not consent to follow me to this land? Shall I then take your son back to the land from which you came?' Abraham replies, 'On no account must you take my son back there. The Lord, the God of heaven that took me from my father's house,' etc., etc., 'He will send his angel before you, and you will get a wife for my son from there. And if the woman does not consent to follow you, you shall then be clear of this oath to me, but do not take my son back there.'" Avraham Avinu says, "I made Aliyah, I'm staying here, my son is going to stay here, he's not going back." And of course, this is also reflected in the story of buying Ma'arat HaMachpelah at the beginning of the parsha for the burial of Sarah, and later on in the parsha when Abraham is buried in Ma'arat HaMachpelah as well. The second basic Jewish value is that of endogamy, to marry other Jews. And that's encapsulated in one verse when Abraham says to his servant, that you will not take a wife for my son from the daughters of the Canaanites among whom I dwell. And of course, later on in the Torah, in the book of Shemot, in the book of Devarim, and later on in the book of Ezra and the book of Nehemiah, this is developed into the Isur, into the prohibition of marrying non-Jews. But here, this is the kernel that Jews should marry other Jews. And the second two values are values ben adam l'chaveiro, ethical commandments. And it's described as follows. When Rivka sees Avraham's servant, the servant ran toward her and said, "Please let me sip a little water from your jar." "Drink, my lord," she said. And she quickly lowered her jar upon her hand and let him drink. When she had let him drink his fill, she said, "I will also draw for your camels until they finish drinking." Quickly emptying her jar into the trough, she ran back to the well to draw, and she drew for all his camels. In other words, we have here two basic ethical concepts. First of all, ve'ahavta l'reacha kamocha, love your neighbor as yourself. In the Mideast, water is not a luxury, it's a necessity. Rivka immediately runs to give water to Eliezer, but not only that, she also worries about his camels, tsar ba'alei chayim, mercy upon living creatures. And finally, just a few verses later, "Batomer elav gam teven gam ispo rav imanu gam makom lalun," and she went down, "There is plenty of straw and feed at home, and also room to spend the night." In other words, what we call in later Jewish tradition, hachnasat rochim, welcoming guests into your home. So in this one chapter in Bereshit, we have four basic Jewish values. The value of Zionism, of making Aliyah and remaining in the land of Israel, the value of endogamy, of marrying other Jews, the value of ve'ahavta l'reacha kamocha, loving your neighbor as yourself, and tsar ba'alei chayim, helping living creatures, and finally, the value of hachnasat orchim, of welcoming strangers into your home. May we take these values with us, not only on Parshat Chaye Sarah, but throughout the year. Shavua Tov from Schechter.